Meta Box Warwick Fuller, also known as the Sculptor of Horrors. This woman had to fight the oppression that women of color had to face in a time where all the art scene was dominated by white people, and specifically by white men. She was so full of this desire to reinvent the archetype of the black in the moment. It is important to mention aspects of her life that definitely contributed and influenced her art throughout the years. When she was born in America, she was born to a family that had access to some things that older black families did not have. She had the opportunity to get involved with art, and this is something that she would do with her father. They would go and visit museums. She found the sculptures delightful, and it kind of clicked in her that that's what she wanted to do. When she was 22 years old, she moved to France with the intention to pursue her education. Her plan was to live in this club for girls that wanted to study art in Paris. To her surprise, she was rejected to be accepted to live there because she was not a white woman. A few months into discovering all these techniques, she meets W.E.B. Du Bois, and she would become someone that he protected, and not only protected, but he also encouraged her and he supported her career. Of course, a big name, a scholar like Du Bois, he became a way for Fuller to access more opportunities, and that's what she wanted to do. She wanted to be able to bring her art many places. So what she does is that she gets involved in all this, in this art scene, and he actually invites her to be part of a project where she could be part of an exhibit to create and honor the Black American culture. She would receive the nickname of the Sculptor of Horrors because her unapologetic way of expressing the feelings and the sentiment of the Black people that were murdered and killed and abused. So she was unafraid to show it. The women that would make it in the art scene would be doing all the textile type of art, which is nothing bad. It was a limited field, and she decided to go beyond that. So she decided to do a sculpture that wasn't associated to men because of the effort, the physical effort of creating sculptures and how heavy and tiring this process can be, but also she decided to go full on not being afraid of showing and depict images that would express sadness and horror and the pain and the sentiment of a whole community. So one of the most important pieces that she ever created was in memory of Mary Turner. And Mary Turner was a woman that was protesting after her husband was lynched, and she was also victim of a white mob, and she was lynched herself. In the case of the Mary Turner sculpture, that one remained plaster, painted with a metallic coat that would simulate the appearance of bronze. Notice how from the pedestal or the base where this woman is standing, her body, her dress, it almost fades into this base, and we can, in the wrinkles of this tunic or dress that she is wearing, we can also find some hands. And pay special attention to this, because none of these elements are a coincidence. This woman was attacked by a mob and was lynched in this way, so we can observe elements in her dress. There are kind of like hands are trying to drag her as she is in a like a really vulnerable position. Her body seems vulnerable, and she's looking down to those elements that seem to be holding onto her. We cannot see a clear depiction of the face, but we can sense, based on the body language of this sculpture, how she is in motion, how as she's being dragged, she is looking down, and she's looking at her at the people that are attacking her. It is not surprising because it almost became her style. There is not a lot of negative space in this sculpture. When talking about sculptures and talking about space, it's kind of tricky to understand the concept, but the positive space is that space that the sculpture actually occupies, and that negative space is that a space in between or around. And believe it or not, this creates and it changes a lot in a piece. For example, if there is a sculpture where we talk about negative space, if there is a sculpture where hands are over the head and they're like holding, and all this empty space, all this space in between the face of the sculpture and the arm, that is what we call negative space. So in a lot of Fuller's sculptures, we observe that they are expressed in kind of like in a totem way. This is something that we're gonna observe throughout some of her work. Another piece that explains a little bit why Fuller received the nickname of the sculpture of horror is Danse Macabre, which means dance of death. And this sculpture that was made in 1914, we can see what seems to be the like bodies, like some kind of like people wearing like long tunics, and their faces show really dark emotions. Fuller was always playing with these feelings. Dance of Death is a sculpture that can be seen from different angles. It seems a little bit odd to imagine that a sculpture can show motion, but certainly the fact that these characters are wearing these tunics and they seem to be flowing in the air, it shows a lot of motion. The next piece that I want to show you, it's called Sorrow, and this one really hit home because it seems to show what is a mother embracing her dead child. We can see how she is holding the body of this baby. Sorrow is another plaster made sculpture. It was painted in gold color. This sculpture is approximately 5 by 4 by 5 inches, and it is presented on a base of the same material. The following sculpture follows the same idea of playing with the elements of horror and also showing a lot of the sentiment and the pain of the Black people. In the Talking Skull, which is said to be based on a story, on a folk story, where a young man finds a skull on the ground and this skull is talking to him. The rendition of Fuller for this story results in a magnificent piece that was developed in bronze. We can see that there is a lot of negative space in this sculpture. As we can see, there is a space in between the arm of the young man that is addressing this skull. And nowadays, this piece can be found in the Museum of African American History in Boston. The following sculpture is one of my favorite ones because it involves a lot of different characters. In the same scene, we can see around 5 or 6 characters or people, and the amount of details is incredible. We can see how Fuller pays attention to every little detail in the body. We can observe the nudity of some bodies, and also we can see some faces that just seem to be carrying so much pain and sadness in it. This piece was fortunately was cast in bronze. And the physical dimensions of this piece is 21 by 17 by 15 inches, and it is titled The Gretchen. So Fuller was really into paying attention to the details and creating stories with the texture of her pieces. And for the last piece, I say one that to me englobes and wraps up the entire idea and the mission of Fuller to portrayed the Black community under a different light. In this case, I'm talking about Ethiopia. It was initially baptized Marquette for Ethiopia and later was known as Ethiopia Awakening. So this one in particular takes a turn because it involves, it goes beyond the African-American story, but it goes to these roots in Africa. And what is beautiful about this piece is that we can see how these person with a really pleasant face. And the way she describes this is that it symbolizes the awakening of the Black community, how the Black community sheds all these bandages from a mummified past, full of sadness, full of horror, of death, and it's awakening, and it is expectant, but unafraid. And these are words that definitely, ever since I read them, they are now stuck in my brain, because there is a lot of intention behind these words. Later on in the same year, 1921, Fuller would cast this sculpture in bronze. If we analyze the piece itself, it might not be the most, it doesn't have like this elaborated and difficult design. It provides, and it has a lot of details, yes, and have different textures, but there is not a lot of negative space. Certainly we don't see a lot of motion in the piece, but it is mostly, it's the meaning, it's the social demand, it's the message that Fuller is bringing to the public, is honoring the realness of the Black empires and the Black people. And this is the piece that made me fall in love with Fuller's work, because it is charged with a lot of emotions, and it has a very simplistic and unique beauty.